Welcome to Art History with Jackie. Today, we will be talking about Frida Kahlo, a Mexican painter known for her self-portraits, works inspired by nature, and surrealist themes. Kahlo was born to a German father and a mestiza mother. Mestiza means that she is of mixed European and indigenous descent. Kahlo was born in 1907 in a village on the outskirts of Mexico City. Her father was artistic and worked as a photographer. She described her childhood home as sad because her parents were often sick. When Kahlo was six, she contracted polio, which made her right leg shorter and thinner than the left. This illness forced her to be isolated from her peers for months, and she was bullied a lot at school. Her time at home made her very close to her father, who was also living with the disability of epilepsy. She worked with him in his photography studio. Kahlo bounced around from school to school as an elementary student, but in 1922, she was accepted to the National Preparatory School to focus on natural sciences with the aim of becoming a doctor. While there, she became an avid reader and became seriously immersed in and committed to Mexican culture, political activism, and social justice. The school promoted indigenismo, a new sense of Mexican identity that took pride in the country's indigenous heritage and sought to rid itself of the colonial mindset of Europe. This then influenced her art. In 1925, Frida and her boyfriend Arias were on their way home from school when they were in a bus accident that resulted in several deaths. Kahlo was impaled with an iron handrail that went through her pelvis. She suffered many injuries, spent a month in the hospital, and 5 months recovering at home. The accident ended Kahlo's dreams of becoming a doctor and caused her pain for the rest of her life. During her time at home, Frida began to paint. This was how her artistic career began. She began to consider a career as a medical illustrator, which would combine her interests. Painting became a way for Kahlo to explore questions of identity and existence. She painted herself often. In 1928, Kahlo was introduced to Diego Rivera at a party held by the Mexican Communist Party. Despite him being 20 years her senior and having two other common law wives, they began a relationship. Rivera was a well-known Mexican artist who had achieved fame and success in Mexico as well as the United States. Rivera and Kahlo moved to Morelos in 1929. While there, she changed her artistic style and began to draw more inspiration from Mexican folk art. When Kahlo and Rivera moved to San Francisco in 1930, Kahlo was influenced by other American artists. The 6 months they spent there were a productive period for Kahlo, who developed the folk art style she had begun to experiment with in Mexico. At this point, she was not recognized as an artist in her own right, but rather as Rivera's wife. When the couple moved to Detroit, Frida experimented with different techniques and themes. Her paintings began to show a stronger narrative style, and she began to place an emphasis on terror, suffering, wounds, and pain. In 1934, Kahlo returned to Mexico City. She divorced and then reconciled with Rivera and spent the years of 1937 and 38 being more productive than she had ever been. This was the point when she began to receive recognition as an artist in her own right. She was receiving commissions from international patrons, such as A. Conger Goodyear, the president of the MoMA. She became a member of the Seminario de Cultura Mexicana, a group of artists commissioned by the Ministry of Education in 1942 to spread public knowledge of Mexican culture. Despite her recognition and success, Kahlo's health was declining rapidly. In her first and last solo exhibition in Mexico, Frida had her four-poster bed rolled into the gallery. She passed away in 1954. Kahlo has been named one of the most significant artists of the 20th century. She is one of Mexico's most important 20th century figures. She has gained popularity as a feminist icon, and her work continues to enchant viewers posthumously. Thank you, and see you next week.